beautiful.
It is. Well, the stage is set for what will be a blockbuster AFL grand final. Geelong taking on the Swans after the Lions were robbed at the weekend, the great dance at the G.
It was so close, though, that one, wasn't it?
It was close, all right?
Well, it comes after a night of glitz and glamour with, of course, the annual Brownlow Medal Awards back in Melbourne. It was so good to see. And Nine Sports presenter Tony Jones joins us now.
Did he get all frocked up last night?
Well, he wasn't officially invited.
Well, hang on. Let's get a couple of things straight. I am all still frocked up because I actually have come straight from there. And secondly, I was invited. I was always invited. It took a little dummy spit to get there. But anyway, I was invited and on an AFL table. And it was a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful night.
Jeez, it sounds like you're a bit Carl Stefanovic.
Which isn't a compliment.
No, don't ever say that. No, I'm not. No, it was fine. No.
All right, sorry, mate, sorry. Fair enough. Listen, Carlton's Patrick Cripps.
No.
What a legend. Yeah. Gee, he had a big year.
Well, he had a big year, but I think the thing about Patrick Cripps is it's the Patrick Cripps off the field that everyone is just so impressed with, because he is a remarkable young man. And the way he spoke about his family, he's from country WA and from the farm, and spoke about how his dad in 2006, 2007, I think it was, that era with the big drought, how he battled through it and, you know, never changed his demeanour. And it was just absolutely beautiful the way he spoke about his family. And they were there to help celebrate with him, along with his fiancée. So he is a remarkable young man. And if, I guess any sporting administrator would love a list full of Patrick Cripps, not only because of his football prowess, but just because of the young man that he is. And there wasn't a person in the room who begrudged him that honour last night.
There's a real calmness about him, I reckon. He's got that kind of country calmness. Terrific to watch.
Mm.
Yeah, well, it's interesting also that, it's the stories that we don't know. And one he shared last night, in that when he first got to the club in about, must have been 2016 perhaps, he couldn't talk. He had a very bad stutter, and he would watch his then captain Mark Murphy face the media and thought, I wish I could actually talk like that. I've got the stutters myself now, but I wish I could actually talk like that as well. And he worked with the club to actually get a speech therapist to work with him, and that allowed him to be the orator that he was last night on stage. So all these obstacles needing to overcome with his self-confidence, etc., etc., and now he stands as a Brownlow medalist, and a very worthy one, as I say. Mm.
Which just sends a really beautiful message to any young kids who saw that, who might have that same struggles, to know that they can achieve that. It was beautiful. I love seeing he seemed really overwhelmed by it all. Let's talk about the games at the weekend. I mean, Geelong, it was an annihilation of the Lions. And of course, 1 point. Your team went down by 1 point, TJ.
What's wrong with her?
Look, I tell you what, was that a laugh? Why are you even laughing at that? I mean, Collingwood supporters are really hurting this morning and you're all laughing. But
I know, that's
terrible.
Actually true.
But look, the one thing about that is it was an occasion at the SCG, and to see where the code has come from the time that the struggling South Melbourne was relocated to get crowds of nearly 50,000, I think it was the third biggest at the SCG, remarkable. But look, Collingwood, as a Collingwood supporter, very, very proud of what they've achieved this year, to come from second last, only a point or two away from making it to the grand final. But I tell you what, Sydney was lucky. Like Tom Papley, there was a deliberate push in the back there to Darcy Moore. The umpire let it go, and that was definitely the turning point there. So, Tom Papley, I tell you what, you are one lucky young man, and the Sydney Swans, you know, you dodged a bullet there, but I hope for your sake that you make the most of it and you can go all the way, but it's going to be very tough against Geelong.
TJ, great stuff as always. It was a terrific night last night. You look resplendent this morning. Just want to show everyone at home this picture again, and a national reminder last night, this beautiful wife, of why she should have dropped you like a dead donkey years ago.
Still time.
I'm not sure about that. Thanks, TJ.
He'll happily move into a batch pad with Archie.
And this is exciting, folks. Carlton AFL captain Paddy Cripps has won his first Brownlow Medal in a nail-biting count, beating out favourite Lachie Neal with 29 votes. Here is the moment the young West Australian took out the prestigious award.
Carlton P. Cripps, 3 votes, and I declare the winner of the 2022 Brownlow Medal is Patrick Cripps of the Carlton Football Club.
What a magical moment, and it means so much to that young man, and the Blues superstar, I'm very pleased to say, joins us right now from Melbourne to celebrate. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Paddy Cripps. Round of applause. Paddy, scale of 1 to 10, how hungover are you right now?
I'd go close to 10. It's been a long night, but it's all worth it. It's been great fun. I've had a fair few mates here and obviously family to celebrate. So, it's a weird feeling being outside so early, but it's all worth it.
Mate, thank you so much for getting yourself out of bed, if you actually went to bed to be with us this morning. But I want to ask you what this means to you, this award. I know your family and the hugs with your mum and your dad, and I think it was your brother as well afterwards. Just take us through those moments afterwards with your family, who I know mean so much to you.
Oh, look, it's, we've always loved footy growing up, and we're from a small country town, and, I always remember watching the Brownlow as a kid, and, to play AFL is a dream come true, and then, you win, the Brownlow medal, you never dream of that stuff, and I'm always really close to my family and my fiancée, and, you sort of ride the highs and lows with them together. And, there's been a lot of lows in my career, but there's also been some great highs. And last night was one of those. So it's always great to share with family.
Yeah, you've battled a lot of injuries over your time, Paddy. Yeah, what does that mean to come through that and be standing there with that Brownlow around your neck?
Yeah, it's obviously a massive honour. I was sort of going to this year, there's a lot of chatter sort of around my body and things like that, but I sort of went into the year, just put my head down, and I knew what I was capable of, and sort of wasn't really proving people wrong. I was sort of proving myself right in a way that, I knew I was capable of what I could do, and, I'm a big believer in the off-season sets up your pre-season, and your pre-season sets up your season. So, last year I just put my head down and put myself in the best position to attack pre-season, and I was able to complete a full pre-season, and that led to a good year. So there's no secret to, I suppose, success. It's just a lot of hard work, and you just got to keep backing that up year after year.
Well, 20 goals this year, amazing season high for you. Hey, you came ninth the Mighty Blues this year. What do you got to do? How do you turn it around for next season?
It was a tough pill to swallow, not going to lie. I've never played in the final before, but, the last game of the year was as close to a final atmosphere as you can get. But, we played some really, really good footy this year. I've got a lot of belief in the group, and it's probably a game situation, game awareness that we probably need to work on a little bit in the pre-season. But, with the talent on our list, and I know how hard the guys work, and I'm really confident going into next year.
Good on you, mate. How much sleep have you had, just out of interest, Paddy?
If you look at my eyes, you can probably tell not a lot. But, I'm crying out for a bit of sleep right now. But, you got to do it. It's all worth it when you're in the Brownlow. So, just got to keep punching out the next few hours, and then I'll be hitting the pillow pretty quick.
Good on you, mate. Well done. I know one bloke in particular knows his way around turning up the next day, whatever happened the night before, and that man's Carl Stefanovic. Carl, do you have any advice for young Paddy?
Yeah, I just wanted to say, Cripsy, well done, my friend. We've been following you really well this year, and you just had a terrific year. But one thing I will give advice to you, if you're staying at Crown, you're going to an awards ceremony the night before, just make sure you don't leave your eyes in the villa when you come down to do the cross.
Mate, not going to lie, mate, my eyes, once I have 2 beers, I'm done. So you can probably tell my eyes, I left my eyes definitely in the count last night.
Oh, well.
What a legend.
I think you've out-logied Carl.